Hello, hello. Welcome to another video on the channel where healing and spiritual growth are front and center. Today's shout out goes to Susan D. Thank you for your continued support. Now today we're going to dive into something that was brought to my attention, and this is inspired by another fellow warrior, Jason Thomas. I feel like we need to dive a little bit more into this because there are side effects to narcissistic abuse. And a lot of you know this, but for those who are just coming out of that situation or that abuse, okay, I want you to just take your time. Don't beat yourself up, okay? But I'm going to talk about three very important things, okay? Number one, because you're still coming out from under that cloud of cognitive dissonance. So What has happened though throughout the abuse and all of that stuff, the crazy making with it, what that goes hand in hand with is how the system of narcissism has done that indoctrination of impatience. Now I have a part one and a part two previous videos all about that, but this kind of branches out from that, and it is how it has tricked many people into thinking that anybody they meet going forward is also looking for instant gratification. And I want you to understand that it's a normal response, okay? And over time, you will overcome that. So just know that, all right? And so what I've done with that is, it leads into the second point I want to make about apologizing for no reason. I have another video about that previous video. I'll link all of those in the description and in the card and stuff like that, because those two go hand in hand. Because if, let's say, someone sends you a text message or an email or something like that, and I know I've talked about this from how the narcissistic abuse, how the abusers often will expect an immediate response. That's how they are. And so what has happened is that has gotten some, because you got so used to in that situation or in that abusive relationship, what happens is you got used to having to provide that for the abuser. So that's why I say it's a natural thing when you first come out and you start on that road of recovery. It is a natural reaction because it's something you got conditioned. It's what the system of narcissism conditioned people to think and to do. Like, you got to be on your feet quick with everything. And so it takes a little while to get out from under that and to overcome that. So just keep that in mind, and just know that there are many of us out here who we're not like that, okay? So that, hopefully that gives some reassurance to some of y'all, that if you're feeling like you're feeling bad, if you didn't get, you know, like if you didn't respond right away or you're feeling bad, just know that's what I call, what I like to call, a residual side effect of coming out from that abusive situation, where whether it be the workplace or the, you know, the home, a spouse, partner, whatever, dating relationship, whatever, if you've been in it for any length of time, what it had done, it had tricked the brain, it kind of programmed that brain into always giving that abuser instant gratification. So when we first come out, that's how we're thinking. And so we think that that's, well, it's kind of like we think it's normal. Okay, because remember, narcissism has been normalized. Narcissistic abuse has been normalized. So again, just for those who have not heard it and are new to this channel, there are some welcome videos. There's plenty of information. You know, some of these videos are older when we first get started and we're testing out new equipment. But anyway, the information is most important, the content itself, because I talk about many things that come with narcissistic abuse and what it's done. And I also bring the spiritual perspective always, because it is a spiritual battle between narcissists and empaths. And what happens, the empath comes out and gets away from that, and we often do right in the beginning, we have that ingrained in our mind that, oh my gosh, and we're going to feel bad if, let's say, someone that's not the abuser, you know, they send us a message, however they do it, and so we'll start to feel bad if we don't respond right away. So I don't want anyone, if you are messaging me and I don't get right back to you, or you don't get right back to me, don't worry about it. Okay, I know it could, that it's that cognitive dissonance, but I just want to reassure everyone that we're not all like that. But it also does take time to get to that point where you'll understand and you'll start to relax a little bit more. Okay, it does happen. So this can be some encouragement for you all. And so we don't want to feel obligated to apologize for not getting. Now, I will apologize if I didn't catch the question or whatever it is, at least within a week, all right? That's why I often tell people over on Quora, too, if I haven't seen your comment or question yet, just bear with me. I am still going through all of those, and I will get to them as soon as possible, mind you, if it requires a response, because I don't always get those notifications. So keep that in mind, but yeah, and I will say, excuse me for the delayed response, but now you'll know why. It's like, I didn't get it. Yeah, I didn't get the notification or whatever. But, you know, that kind of thing, that's different. It's kind of where you do want to use that discernment also, you know, as to whether or not that correspondence needs a response or not. Now, if someone's asking you a question, then yeah, most likely, eventually you want to get around to it. But just know that not everybody out there goes by that instant gratification. There are a lot more people out there that have far more patience than we realize, okay? It is one of those things that stage of recovery when you're starting to heal, it's just one of those things you'll have to overcome, and you will, okay? So again, it goes along with that being patient with yourself. I know it's tough sometimes because that system of narcissism has got so many people into that. Like I said in the other videos, it's like they've got everybody thinking you have to rush. And we want to remember that our Heavenly Father doesn't operate like that. You know what I'm saying? He doesn't operate in a rush, hurry up, get it done kind of way. God doesn't work that way. And there are a lot more people out there who understand that people are busy, people are doing other things. We do. Okay, we understand people got stuff going, especially if you've got kids and other things going on, other projects. In fact, a lot of us have projects going on all the time, but it's just a matter of prioritizing and things like that. And you get there, I know, that's another side effect of narcissistic abuse. When you're first coming out and you enter that recovery, it does take a little while to gain your, you know, to get your feet grounded on, you know, grounded a little bit. It takes a little bit. So I want everyone to know that don't worry if you're still struggling with, let's say, time management or trying to figure out how to put together a productive to-do list and not overwhelm yourself. You'll get there. You will. Once you're away from a toxic environment or toxic people over a period of time, when you stay away, you start developing boundaries. Okay, when you start developing boundaries and things like that, it'll all come. And it can come naturally, too. So we don't have to rush that. We don't ever want to do that. That's why a lot of us are out here when we work with survivors. And we say the one thing you want to do, is like again, with that being patient with yourself, is just to know that those of us who are well ahead and well over that cloud, we're well in God's reality, we understand exactly where you are at and what you're going through, because we were once there ourselves. Because when you first come out, it does all of that stuff that got projected in your brain. You know, your brain gets rewired during that narcissistic abuse, and the enemy knows this, and that's part of why he has all of his little flying monkeys engaging in the abusive behavior, because the whole point is to rewire that brain, okay? Let's think about that, because it's a big part of disconnecting you from mind, body, and spirit. Because once the narcissistic abuser can do that, then it's pretty much, it takes a little while to get everything turned back around the way that it's supposed to be, the way that God made it, okay? And eventually you'll get to that point and you'll notice. And a lot of people, when we first get out of that, that's one of the first things we notice, is how everything just got flipped. It was like a big flip the script. And so as time goes on, we start to notice more and more. And then there are a handful of us that have connected it all to biblical scripture. So this is just a quick reminder. That's what you'll get on this channel. Okay. And I'll talk a lot about all the different aspects. And sometimes I'll do a part two or a part three if something comes to my attention like this, because it's very important. And so I just want everyone to keep that in mind, and it comes, it will, it'll you'll get there. So don't beat yourself up, because it's you got that fog, you know, that brain fog that gets induced. A lot of that is, you know, it's from the abuse, okay? Because remember, during that abuse, like I just said before, that brain gets rewired, okay? And we actually, not that we ever had complete 100% backwards thinking like the narcissistic abuser does. What happened is, over time, when they start to reveal themselves, they start to tell on themselves, and you start having to Google their behavior, okay, then you know, okay, that pretty much starts the lifting of the fog, okay? That starts a rewiring, okay? It's like, that's God, okay? That's God waking you up now, and God is showing you, okay, all of those things that, again, that we missed when we were still in the first two realities. I mentioned this often because it's so very important. And I've got my second book. It's all about those three realities. Again, those are the stages of life. You can find those listed under my books and published writings on my website. So if you haven't had a chance to read that one yet, and it's a sequel to the first one about how narcissism is the work of the devil. So you'll see both of those over there on my website, okay? And you'll want to take a peek, and that'll also help you get a better understanding of the content that's on this channel and content that will keep coming on this channel. Okay, now I want to get to the third part of it's another side effect is that uncertainty. And it's totally understandable, because when you first get out and you start your recovery and your healing, there's going to be a lot of that. It's going to feel somewhat overwhelming, but liberating at the same time, because you're getting out of there, right? You're just finally, you're out, you're away. You've been able, eventually, if you haven't been able to go full no contact yet, and you can, you will. Don't beat yourself up about that either. I remind people often, I know, because sometimes they go, oh, why is it so difficult? You know, they keep getting drawn back. It takes a little while. Eventually, we advise against ever going back, because the abuse will get worse, but it happened, okay, until that trauma bond breaks. And so I've got another video all about why we get so easily trauma bonded to a narcissistic abuser. It's because we first got trauma bonded to the world. And that's simply, again, unhealthy attachments to people and things. We're not talking about throwing away all your stuff. That is not what it means. But the uncertainty that you feel when you first come out of that narcissistic abuse relationship, it's normal. Okay, because that fog is lifting, but at the same time, you asking yourself, am I the one that's gone crazy? Because you start to notice narcissistic abuse everywhere, and narcissism in places where you didn't notice it before. And so you'll start to feel crazy, but you're not. You're not crazy. What's happening is that cognitive dissonance is lifting. It's that heavy cloud, that brain fog, it's starting to lift. And so God is rewiring your brain back to the way it needs to be, to, you know, basically flipping the script back in the direction that it's supposed to be, so you'll be able to see more of what he's going to show you. Okay? So you just want to remember that. And it take it, and the time that it takes is different for everyone. Okay? I have said that before. Because it also really depends on how long you were in that abusive situation or in that abusive relationship. Okay? It's going to depend on how long. But also, it's going to depend on how often or how much you stay with the Godhead. Okay? How much you continue to put God first. Because the more you do that, the more that you put God first, the less uncertain you will feel. The less uncertainty you will feel. The less, you know, feeling as if you're going crazy. That'll go away. That'll go away. When you stay with God, you stay with the Heavenly Father, you stay with Him, you put Him first every single day, He will hasten you. Again, Isaiah 60:22 tells us this, it's plain as day. We stay with Him, we put God first always, and He will hasten it in His time. So, that gives you something to think about. So if you're at that point where you're feeling a little uncertain, just know that's normal. We all go through it, and it does dissipate. It does dissipate. You just want to give it the time that it needs. I know we all go through that period of, oh my gosh, you know, we want it to hurry up and go away. But we got to let God do what He needs to do. All right, everyone, so just those 3 points. Don't beat yourself up. If you're feeling like everyone you meet is looking for instant gratification, just know that we're not. There's a lot more of us out there than you think, and we understand. We know exactly what that's about, and you don't have to apologize if you don't respond to something. If it's just a general statement of a hello or whatever, you know, like if let's say if I ask you how was your day and you haven't gotten back to me until the next day, that's fine. Nobody is over here expecting an immediate response, because we know everyone's busy, especially during the healing process. There's a lot that takes place, and there's a lot that's gonna happen. So just keep that in mind. As always, if you have any questions, just feel free to drop them in the comments below, and I will get to them as soon as I can. Sending love and light to all fellow warriors. Thank you for watching and for your support. Until next time, let's show some gratitude to the Heavenly Father, and you keep being you. In Jesus' name, amen.